Hello students, so today we start chapter 2 of class 4 of PhD, that is name of the chapter electrostatic potential and capacitance, right? That is electrostatic potential and capacitance. First we will discuss about the potential difference. Then we will come to know that is potential due to single charge. Right? You may be familiar with the potential difference that you have studied in class 10. Right? That is first 2 points must be there. If you want to define potential difference, then there must be 2 points and there must be moment of charges. Right, you can define potential difference between 2 points. So first topic is that is potential difference. We say electric potential difference. Electric potential difference or E dot V, E dot V, that is potential difference, right? So first we have to take 2 points to define the electric potential difference. So let us see, we take 2 points V and other is 0. First point A, another point is B. Let at point P there is a unique positive charge. It is known as test charge. It is unique positive charge. That is called. It is called unique positive charge or test charge. It is given by Q on the side. Now see, if this charge is moved from this point to this point, if we want to move the charge from point B to A, then we have to do external work against the electric field. Right? Remember, when work is done in moving a charge against the electric field, then we can define the electric potential difference. For example, let one gun be moving the charge from point B to D, that is given by F. From where you are moving? From B to which point? A. That is external work done by external force, right? From B to A, which charge? We need positive test charge, right? And what is to be done? That is, we have to apply external force against what? That is electrostatic force, right? So it is denoted by WBA, right? Then, how to define the electric potential difference between two points, right? So, electric potential difference. Between point B and A, that is AB, in just like that is potential of A minus potential of A. Right? That is final minus initial. We are moving initial from B to A, so potential of A minus potential of B, right? That is equal to just one term in moving the tail charge from B to A. E divided by test charge. That is electric potential difference defined as work done per unit test charge in moving the tension between the potential, electric potential between two points is highest worked by the external force per unit test charge. In moving, the test charge from one point to another point. That is, work done divided by the test charge. If we see unit, then unit of work done is what? Unit of work done is and unit of charge is coulomb. That is, if you need to use joule, coulomb, inverse. Right? Just remember, it is like work done upon the unit positive charge. Right? So, if we see the SI unit of your potential difference, then it is volt. SI unit of potential difference equal to volt. Right? So next we define that is electric potential of the point. To know about the electric potential, first we should define that electric potential difference. Means always remember the two points. Now we define at a point how to find out the electric potential. Okay? Electric potential at the point of the magnet. So here some assumption is to be made. This I have to define electric potential of point A. Then there will be another point also that was considered as impedance. Just like we define electric potential distance, there was 2 points. Here we define electric potential of point A. Then the other point must be at this point. Right? Let us say B point is situated in finite distance. Right? And also, the potential at infinite is equal to zero. This is the consideration. This we have to assume. Means, to define electric potential of a one point, of single point, the other point must be taken as infinity, and also the, that is, the potential at one must be zero. So, let us place to be positive charge, to be placed positive charge. Now, again, what is that? That is, what are the moving charge from infinity to point A? Now, that is, let us say, from B to A. What is this? This is what are the by external force. Okay? What are the external force? So, and accordingly, we can define that is potential of point A and no way of moving, that is infinity. That is equal to work done is moving the charge from infinity to point A for the charge. This can be written as VA minus VB, that is dead load infinity. Right? So in this way, we can define electric potential or that is electric potential difference or electric potential is a point. Also here the unit will be joule per coulomb, and that is called your SI unit. SI unit is again volt. Right. So next we see one numerical related to this topic. Some points to be noted about the electric potential. Some points, right? And some points is that points to remember, right? Very very important points to remember. And remember the first point. First point is direction. Right. G work must be done. The work must be done against electric field. The work must be done against the electric field, right? This is your first point. And second is right. The work done by external force does not depend any part. In all the cases, the work done will be the same. Why? Because it is part independent, and this type of force is known as the conservative force. Means when you talk about the conservative force, then that is the work done is independent of the part. Right? So first point is work done is done against electric field always. Work done by external force does not depend on the path. That is, you can say, conservative bending force. Right? In this way, you can see that is, in a closed loop, the work done is 0. That is, if you move from A to B, if work done is WAB, then in moving from B to A, that is B to A, will be just equal to minus of BAB. That is work done in a closed loop. That is from point A to B. If it is positive, then from B to A, it will be negative. That is total work done. Here, that is total work done. You can say that is BAB plus minus V. That is total work done in a closed loop is always equal to 0. This is because it is part independent. Also, the work done if it is 10 U, then in coming it will be minus 10 U. Here also it is part independent. Means if it will go from this part and it will come by long part. But since these points are similar, that is, initial point and final points are same, then the total work done in a closed loop will always be 0. This are the properties. This is to remember for one last question. Right? Then you will see one or two numericals related to this. That is potential or electric potential difference.